Lamps that we are using in electrical engineering or in our day-to-day life. As we know that sound is the main source of energy, light energy, or natural source we get in. But in today's world, what we are using? We are using the artificial sources like our fluorescent lamp, incandescent lamp. So like all the electrical lamps that we are using, that we will study in today's class. So let's start our topic. So students, coming to the introduction part, as I have told you right now that sun is the prime or natural source of energy, but we are totally depend upon the artificial energy, artificial lighting. So that lightings are produced by this electrical lamps, and these lamps where we are using, you are using for decorative purposes, advertising, traffic control, medical field, street lighting, and many more. Okay, so now in this class, what we will study? We will study the different terms related to this illumination or lighting and different types of electrical lamps and their working construction and working principle. So these are the lights that you all know. What do you mean by light? That part of radiant energy from a hot body which produced the visual sensation on human eyes is called as light. Okay, so this is the definition of light. We are the result is a visual sensation which is on the human eyes. Then this is the example of light. Then what do you mean by luminous flux? The total quantity of radiant energy per second responsible for visual sensation from a luminous body is called as luminous flux. That means in a body, the amount of radiant energy is producing or is focusing, and due to that we are seeing the object. That is known as luminous flux, and the symbol is A for phi, and its unit is lumen. It is measured in lumen. This is luminous flux. Luminous fluxes which are extracting from this light energy or heat energy. Then lumen means, as I have told you right now, it is a unit of luminous flux, or one lumen is defined as the luminous flux emitted per unit solid angle from a point source on one candle power. So solid angle means within that particular area it will cover, means that is the angle between that area and the distance of that light. So this is, or simply you have to remember that lumen means it is the unit of luminous flux.
Then come to illumination. When light falls on a surface, it becomes visible. This phenomenon is called that we are seeing, means it is the electrical term is illumination. It is a technical term.
It is defined as a luminous flux falling on a surface per unit area, and it is denoted by E. E is equal to phi by A. Phi is the luminous flux and A is the cross-sectional area, and the unit is lux. Then come to the initial lamp, that is the filament lamp, or we can tell it incandescent lamp, means the bulb we are using in our home, that is known as, the technical term is incandescent lamp. So here the technique used is, means here in this case we are simply converting heat energy into light energy. Like when we are using a room heater, when it is switched on, it gives us a red light with heat at working temperature of this much 75 degrees centigrade, and at this temperature the radiation are mostly in infrared regions. This working principle we are using in filament lamp or incandescent lamp, means we are using a filament, we are producing some heat energy, or we are providing some heat energy, and due to the heat energy it will be converted into light energy. So obviously when current is flowing through a conductor, means it will heat, or it will give some temperature, that is I square RT, and at low temperature only the heat is produced, But if we will now raise the temperature up to some far, now that temperature will increase, means that is the result of light radiation. Means light radiation will be there, or it will be go on increasing. So as the filament lamp consists of fine wire of high resistivity material placed in an evaporated one glass bulb is there. Within that the filament, or that is the tungsten filament we are using, and it is operated temperature of 2500 degree centigrade. So here is the bulb, or here is the incandescent lamp, and this is the filament here. This is the glass bulb or outer cover. These are the leads, hole, and this is the cap. But the main arrangement or main is this one. This is the filament. Okay, and this filament is a tungsten filament. It is a tungsten filament enclosed in an evaporated glass bulb, which improves the performance. Some chemical like argon or nitrogen gas are filled there also. Means you have to remember this one also. Within this gas ball, glass bulb, some chemicals like argon and nitrogen gas are filled. Due to that gases, the light will be there. And in this filament, the heat energy is produced within that filament. Then the bulb will glow. Simply, we are having two terminals, one positive, one negative. Means it should be electrical circuit, one positive, one negative. Then the current will flow. When the current will flow, the filament will get heated. And when the temperature will increase, now within this area, means in this area, argon and nitrogen is there. That's why the bulb will glow and the light will be, we are seeing the light. That is the result of this bulb. So this is the properties, which is also most important, of a filament. Filament having some different properties. So it has some high melting point. It should have high melting point, so that it can be operated at high temperature. Means the filament, if it will melt at low temperature, so there is no result, means bulb will fuse. So obviously we have to choose the material as a filament which has high melting point, which will withstand high temperature. Then high specific resistance, so that it produces more heat. Because if the resistance will be there, more resistance means more temperature must be there, so it can withstand, or it will produce more heat. That is I square R T. Then low temperature coefficient, so that filament resistance may not change at operating temperature. Then low vapor pressure, so that it may not vaporize. It is also one important point. And high ductility, so that it may withstand mechanical vibration. So there must be, we are keeping our bulb in a particular area, so there some mechanical vibration must be there. So bulb may be broken. So that's why it has high ductility. It should be high ductile material. So these are the properties of a filament material. Now, so from this class, what we conclude, that in this lamp or in this filament lamp, we are converting heat energy into electrical energy or light energy simply. And the filament used in this lamp is tungsten. And the filament should have high melting point and low temperature coefficient. These are must be there for constructing one incandescent lamp. And if you will go for the important questions, should be, so obviously different terms related to illumination, that what is lumen, what is luminous flux, these are the important terms. Then construction and working of a filament lamp or incandescent lamp, and what are the different properties of filament lamp, like it has low melting point or specific resistance or ductile, whatever the properties of this filament, these are also important for an exam point of view.